When you start to curate a study in BUGSIGDB, the first thing you'll do is click Add a Study at the top of the page. This will bring you to the Create Study page that we're looking at now. The first information that you'll add is the study design. This is a drop-down field, and in this case, with the sample paper that we're looking at, it's an observational, not case-control study. Next, you'll enter the citation. Generally, you can use the auto mode in order to auto-populate based on any one of these identifiers. In this case, I have the DOI queued up. I'll then hit Complete, Inform Data, and Save Page. Now we see that all the information has populated, and we hit Add a New Experiment. On the Edit Experiment page, you'll first add some details about the study and the comparison groups for the signature that you're curating. In our example paper, the location of subjects is China. Then the host species field is a drop-down. We can choose humans here. There's also mice and rats. Body site is where the microbial samples were taken from, which in this case is feces. The condition is the condition that the study is looking at, which here is Graves' ophthalmopathy. You'll then add the group zero name, the control group, versus the cases, the group one. Then you'll define group one, which here is patients with severe and active Graves' ophthalmopathy. You'll then add the sample sizes for each of the groups and any antibiotics exclusion detailed in the paper. Moving into the lab analysis portion, you'll add the type of sequencing, 16S or whole metagenomic, and the sequencing platform as well, which here is IonTorrent.
For the analysis section, you'll first need to select if any data transformation was applied prior to differential abundance testing. Next, you'll enter the statistical test for differential abundance testing and the significance threshold that was used. You'll also need to select if the p-values were corrected for multiple testing. In this example, the test was LEFSA with a threshold of 0.05 with no MHD correction. For the next three fields, you'll enter information only if it's applicable. The Elias score applies when the test is LEFSA. For matched on, you'll enter factors on which subjects have been matched on during selection. Moving on to alpha diversity, you'll select an increased, decreased, or an unchanged result for the corresponding alpha diversity measures. For non-significant results, you'll select unchanged. In this section, you'll only record data for the diversity measures that are mentioned or used in the study. For example, the sample study we're looking at here is using Shannon, Chow 1, Simpson, and richness. Shannon and Simpson diversity results show decreased diversity, whereas the other two have non-significant result, which is why I've selected unchanged here. Once all the information in the experiment section is entered, make sure to select complete and save the page. Once you see the experiment section populated, we'll then click on Add a New Signature to enter the microbiome details. On the Edit Signature page, you'll first need to enter the source and the description of the microbiome signatures. Here, we're recording signatures from Figure 5b of the sample study, and I have a small description of the details of this signature. Next, you'll select direction of this set of signature or the abundance in Group 1. Generally, Signature 1 is the increased group of signatures. In the last field, you'll enter the taxon one by one that are in the increased group. This is an autocomplete field and will populate taxon names that are in the database. If a name cannot be recognized, you can find it in the NCBI taxon identifier by searching it here. Once all the information is entered, make sure to select complete and save the page. After you have entered and saved signature 1, you'll click on Add a New Signature again to enter the second set of signature. For the second set of signature, you'll enter the same source and description as you did in signature 1. But here you'll select decrease for abundance in group 1 and enter all the decreased microbiome in group 1. Once all the form data is completed and saved, we can see the information is populated on the main study page.